Wouldn't it be great to make your 3D prints look unique by placing your logo or other graphics on it, or having an additional setting to reduce stringing problems? And how about getting better curves and arcs while at the same time reducing the size of the resulting G-code? I think this means it's orange t-shirt time again. Because this and a lot more is now possible with the new PrusaSlicer 2.7.0 release.
This video is sponsored by PCBWay.
Just a few months after the 2.6 release and me thinking it couldn't get any better, I was proved wrong. Let me show you the best features right away so you know why it's worth the update. But first, a quick look at the changes from 2.6.0 to the intermediate 2.6.1 minor release, which I think are the best ones.
To do the tests, I quickly constructed a pencil holder in Fusion 360. Here's the pencil cup already loaded into PrusaSlicer. Let's add some text to it by clicking a point on the surface, right-click, add part, text. Let's make it big so we can see the effect. When we choose Use Surface to wrap the text around the object, we clearly see that it gets cut off. We also see that all side faces of the letters are oriented perpendicular to the normal of the center of the text. When we choose Per Glyph, we see the effect is exactly as we expect it to be. All letters are nicely wrapped around the object surface and all side faces of the letters are placed perpendicular to their own normals, not the normal of the center of the text. Connectors were introduced as an option in the cut tool to make putting planar cut parts fit exactly together. It now has an additional connector type to choose, the snap connector. Click on Add Connectors, then choose type snap and place your connector. Adjust the tolerances, the depth, the size, the rotation, the bulge, and the spacing in between and confirm the connectors. Then perform the cut. As long as you don't make the connector too small and the tolerances too tight, it allows for easily snapping parts together, holding them in place. In addition to making planar cuts using the cut tool, you can now make dovetails too. You find it in the mode drop-down menu. Choose dovetail and adjust the settings to your likings. You can change the size, the width, as well as the angle of the flaps. Another setting is the groove angle and the tolerances too. When you're done, perform the cut. After printing, your parts should fit nicely together. Sometimes you need to put as many parts as possible on the build plate. To maximize the usage of your build plate, there's no better way than using the Arrange tool for that task. It automatically tries to place as many parts as possible on the build plate, though not being perfect yet. Again, Prusa improved the Arrange tool so that it now also takes otherwise unused space within objects into account. Right-click the Arrange tool, then from Geometry Handling choose Balanced or Accurate and click on Arrange. That way, you can make even more efficient use of the available space of the build plate when printing multiple objects.
Before diving into the exciting additions we get with a new release, just a quick ad from my sponsor, which is PCBWay. Do your electronic projects still look like this? Or a little more major like this? Getting professional-looking DIY projects like this one has never been easier utilizing the services of PCBWay.
PCBWay offers high-quality PCBs starting as low as $5 for 5 PCBs. Using KiCad with the PCBWay plugin, it is the easiest to get an instant quote. One click prepares and uploads the Gerber files to PCBWay, where you then can adjust and change the available options to your needs, add a stencil, choose their assembly service, and more. Then complete the order to get your professional PCBs within a few business days. Besides that, PCBWay also offers high-quality CNC machining, 3D printing services, sheet metal fabrication and more, which makes PCBWay your one-stop shop, no matter if you're a hobbyist or an established company.
And now let's take a look at what's new in PrusaSlicer 2.7.0. As usual, instead of just scrolling through the release document, I took the most interesting features to a practical test to provide you with the most valuable information.
Who Who doesn't know it? You print several parts at the same time and one part comes off the build plate. Previously, the whole print was ruined. As an Octoprint user, you were lucky if you set PrusaSlicer to emit object annotations for the cancel object plugin to pick one of them and exclude it from further printing, while the rest continues to be printed. That way, at least the remaining parts could finish. This feature has been extended so that you now can choose to emit firmware-specific annotations, which will work with Clipper's exclude object module, Marlin's cancel object feature, or RepRap. In Clipper, it's enabled by adding the exclude object section to the printer config. Then you can use the exclude objects module to exclude any of the parts which failed and save your remaining print. In Marlin, you have to uncomment the line define cancel objects in the advanced configuration, compile and reflash it to your printer. Then you can use GCode M486 to skip objects during an ongoing print. PrusaSlicer 2.6 introduced the text emboss tool. With the 2.7 release, you are no longer limited to text, but can now also use SVG graphics. As with text, the graphics can be used to create a relief on your print object. I quickly constructed a simple keychain in Fusion 360 and loaded it into PrusaSlicer. Then right-click, choose Add Part, SVG, select the SVG, then resize it, scale it down, and position it where you need it. Next, click on Use Surface. That makes the SVG follow the surface of the object. Using the operations, you can have your SVG placed on top of your part, cut out, or even be used as a modifier, for example, to add a fuzzy skin to it. In this example, I used the join, the modifier, and the fuzzy skin option to show you how it looks like. And of course, this works for curved or uneven surfaces as well. Here I put my logo on my pencil cup, which I already used when I showed the improvements made to the text embossing tool. The process is the same. Again, use Add Part SVG to load your SVG, which you want to put on your object. Then adjust the settings in the dialog to your needs. And when you're ready, slice the object and print it.
I'm putting a lot of effort into making these videos concise and informative for you. If you got something out of it, I'd be more than happy if you'd support my ongoing work by subscribing to the channel and leaving a like. That way, you keep me going to create more stuff for you.
GCode macros are a great way to customize what your slicer outputs to your printer. Their power comes from using placeholders, which then are replaced by the current values during the slicing process. But it's very hard to remember all of them or to look them up. PrusaSlicer 2.7 now comes with a custom G-code editor, providing a comprehensive list of all available placeholders, which you can add to your G-code macro just by double-clicking them. On top of that, you get a short description of what each of the placeholders does, so no more need to look them up in your web browser. Another new feature in PrusaSlicer 2.7 is binary G-code. When you normally slice your model, you get a text file containing the instructions for your 3D printer in readable form, line by line. The text format makes it also quite easy to edit them using a text editor to change values or to use post-processing scripts to modify them. For complex objects, this can result in very large G-code files. To reduce the file size, especially for transferring the G-code to print services on the web, Prusa introduced the new binary G-code format. When you activate it and reslice your model, you get a file which is no longer human readable. Using binary G-code can save up to 70% of the original file size. Currently, the new file format is only supported by original Prusa printers like the MK4, the Mini, or the Prusa XL. One downside of binary G-code is that you can't see what's going on by looking into the file. One way is to use PrusaSlicer to convert the file back to ASCII format. You can also download a command line tool provided on the libgcode GitHub page to convert from bgcode to ASCII and vice versa. It is very useful to do batch conversions to compress and uncompress a bunch of files in one go. Since the format is open source and because of the already existing libgcode library, we may see it being supported one day in other firmware like Marlin or Clipper. If you don't own one of these Prusa printers, there's still one feature which not only reduces the size of your G-code, but also results in smoother arcs and curves. With the G-codes G2 and G3, circular and arc movements can be defined in just one line of G-code, where the traditional method used many small segments to interpolate the arc or circle. This does not only produce many lines of G-code, but also a heavy processing load which can slow down the printer. The feature can be used on any 3D printer whose firmware has built-in support for these G-codes, which currently is Clipper and Marlin. To enable the support in Clipper, it's sufficient to add G-code arcs to the printer config. The optional resolution parameter allows to choose another value than the default 1.0. To enable the arc support for printers running Marlin, you have to enable the arc support in the advanced configuration, recompile the firmware, and flash it on the 3D printer. You find the new feature in the advanced section in PrusaSlicer. It's disabled by default. You can enable it choosing the drop-down Enable G2 G3. After reslicing your model, the new G-codes are placed in the resulting G-code. Without arc fitting, each arc or circle is divided into many small segments, making a lot of G-code lines for your printer to process. For the line in this example, this means a reduction of G-code by more than 20%. Travel lift, as well known as Z-hop, was introduced in slicers to reduce the likelihood of knocking parts from the build plate when moving the printhead from one location to another. Unfortunately, Z-hop often introduces blobs and stringing that have to be counteracted by using a higher retraction value. Michael from Teaching Tech came up with the idea of using a sloped Z-hop to reduce the stringing caused by perpendicular Z-hops. It works by continuously moving the nozzle up and away from the current print position in a specified direction until it reaches the target Z-height. Then it travels further to the target position and moves downward to continue printing. The improved travel lift feature is supposed to help prevent stringing. In some cases, and especially when I used it with a stringing test, it introduces a nasty other problem. Looking at the generated G-code, we see that it makes a helical movement before starting the slope upwards. Generally, I think it's a good idea because it wipes the oozed filament of the nozzle before the move, but because the circular move is done partly outside of the test part, a tiny amount of oozed filament sticks there, causing these ugly artifacts. Interestingly, the helical movement doesn't seem to be used always. I still see room for improvements here. At least one option to turn off the additional helical wiping move would already help.
I hope you liked the video. And if so, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and giving me your thumbs up. Comments are always welcome too. Don't forget to check out my library to see my other videos. Happy 3D printing and see you next here on 3D Printing Geek.